We're here at the National Cricket Performance Centre in Loughborough, where the ECB's performance team is based. And we're here today to investigate the time differences between different techniques of taking the ball when the fielders throw to make runouts. With the 2019 Cricket World Cup and the 2017 ICC Champions Trophy, we're definitely looking in detail at all the little things we can do in fielding, in batting, and in bowling that might make that difference to sort of tip the odds in England's favour. And so in the fielding area, taking our catching chances and taking our run-out chances and putting the batting team under pressure is a big element of what we're trying to achieve. So this is a small part that might contribute to those increases in performances.
Standing behind the stumps is easy. Anybody can sort of do it, you know, and that's, we all just went for the easy option. You're very rarely going to miss the stumps because you can see them. The ball takes longer to get to you, so you got, you know, it's going to be coming slower. You may be reaching front occasionally. Duncan Fletcher did some work and started to bring this in.
We've set up the bowling machine and that will fire balls in at the stumps in a similar speed and trajectory to how a fielder would throw, but the bowling machine gives us a level of consistency, and we'll then collate all that data using the Hawkeye system, which is a technology specific to the National Cricket Performance Centre, as our timing device where we've got cameras from all angles, so we'll be able to pick up the timing of the ball release and the catch, and then we'll collate all that data, analyse it, and we'll be able to compare the time differences between the different techniques.
When we decided to do the test, I thought it'd be good to get someone who was competent at doing both in front and behind. I went for Ben Cox, who's plays for Worcester, and his coach is Stephen Rhodes, who's also an advocate of this technique, because it's also a fielding thing. I thought it would be interesting to get a bowler, so I went for James Treadwell. So that was to get from a fielding stroke bowling perspective as well.
The results showed that if the throw is coming in left or right and missing the stumps, clearly missing the stumps, then the new technique in front is a lot faster. But what surprised us was when we did the analysis, it wasn't the fact that it was a quicker interception time, it was also the fact that it was one single quick movement, and standing in front, setting yourself up in the right way, allows you to do that. It was the wicketkeeper, Coxey, who was so good at the technique and so fast at it, and he was consistently faster, whereas for Treaders, the bowler, maybe doesn't practice it quite as much. Even though we thought he was good at it, he was actually quite, you know, when we've put the stopwatch on him, he's actually a little bit inconsistent. So there'd be an argument for him to stick with the traditional technique because he was more reliable and accurate with that. But I think there's definitely, it's definitely faster. It could be up to about a yard faster in terms of the batsman running in, and that coaches and players should have a good think about it and practice it to get good at it.